quickly get a very good partner from Taiwan, Vietnam, and also other countries. So this is our action plan. We want to collaborate and also connect the people in different fields. And we focus on not just only the business, which Chris and Alex will just share with you guys. And we will focus on the education and training. R&D, which is one student interested in R&D, and also the services, and also the technology transfer, and also come for investment. This word is just for the examples in my field, in my division, which is the medical and health science. So we have conducted quite a lot of activity already, and I would share with you. VNEAT, just a few months ago, this is the key important person who started with some idea, and we have second meeting, and the third meeting we invite quite a lot of people from Taiwan and Vietnam, and also the fourth meeting. So we are growing up stronger and bigger. For the some activity we have conducted, about the academic activity, because we also have a business activity, and which is very, it's prominent, it's kind of equals priority in our association. So for the academic association, we also work with some very good institutes in Taiwan. And also so we visit the MOSD and some hospitals and also the university to open the gate for a variety of the collaboration in training and also the services. And the other business, because now we think about not just only connect the people to do the R&D, but we also want to start up. We encourage the people from different division. We have a 12 division. Every division, you can start up your own company and your own business. We also visit the high-tech Hua Lạc High Technology Park in my country. It's a big one from Ministry of Science and Technologies. And we also visit some other association to initiate the cooperation. And just last week, we Mr. Duan and I also visit some institutes, institution and so company and association in Taiwan. We discuss quite a lot of the potential market and the potential field we can work together between Taiwan and Vietnam. And that's very quick, because later on, Mr. Dai would present some challenges and opportunity between Taiwan and Vietnam, and also how we can develop our association. So let's talk about connecting. We connect the resources and also talents together, and we initiate the collaboration between Vietnam and Taiwan and other countries in terms of the medical services. This is a very focused point and a great culture, infrastructure, innovative-oriented industries. And to develop the platform or incubator for talent to develop and also to connect and do the business. And finally, we want to do the international linkage in the science park, which is we also do the business and also the R&D. So I will let Mr. Dai talk about the challenges and also the opportunities of our association. Mr. Dai.
Okay, thank you so much for kind introduction. Good evening, everyone. My name is Jackie. Actually, my name is Jackie. It's in English, where my name is Jackie. So I'm very happy to be here today and come back to my home, GGC. Because one year ago, I have already made, we have made a team night, Vietnamese team night. We talk about Vietnam culture, and also we talk about some opportunity. And 1 year today, I come back, and I hope that today I will give you some new information, update information about the opportunity left behind for Taiwanese, for other international students, or for other business. So actually, I'm the director of the Computer Science and Information Technology Divisions in the Vietnamese Experts Association. Meanwhile, I also doing the PhD program at National Taipei National Taipei University of Technology, from Professor. Yeah, you come from the same university, And today, what I'm going to talk about, actually, is, I'm going to have a lot of, I think that we are a lot of things that are a lot of things we can talk. Okay, I'm just allowed to. Okay. Sorry. Open this. Wait a minute. I think there are a lot of things talk about the business, investment. I'm going to talk about the business. If you're looking for some opportunity for invest in Vietnam and also for helping the Taiwan economy to invest in Vietnam, as a uniform, just talk that if you want to invest and you want to start up, you need to understand the local. That is the key point if you want to alive at the beginning, okay? So I will go talk about the Vietnam and Taiwan investment cooperation. That we will give some information. And after that, we'll give some demands. We're raising some demands because growth of demands will driving new opportunities. And then we'll talk about the VNEAT cooperation strategy. And let me start with the first part for the investment. Can you guess, if you think about Vietnam, it's one of the fastest growing economy in the world now. And which is the biggest investor in Vietnam? Can you guess which country? Korean?
I think Taiwan, maybe.
Okay. why don't you think about China and America? It's a giant country.
Because they also have their own business to focus. So, I mean, to support the other country, probably the not too big. Countries.
Oh, yes. I'll give you the answer. Here you can see the top 10 country is the biggest investor in Vietnam. So people, people see, here's a Korean. Here, congratulations, George Rice. Korea is the biggest investor in Vietnam. And they have more than $48 billion invested in Vietnam so far. And luckily, Taiwan, if you compare Taiwan to American and China's, Taiwan is a little bit limited, right, to make a comparison. But Taiwan is one of the biggest, is the number four investor in Vietnam. So that means Taiwan consider Vietnam is one of really important market to invest in Vietnam. And here is just consider about the quantity. Now we take a dip into what is the FDI investment flow. So most of the investment focus on the manufacturing industry. And I think that you can easy to find the information on the internet for the FDI and the FDI float. But later on I give you why I select this information to give you and what is our true reason. And you can see that, what? Here is the bill rate change between Vietnam and Taiwan. You can see that Vietnam actually is if you compare the export and import between those countries, Vietnam import a lot of the product. The value of export here is very minority to compare to the export compared to the import. So we can see the gap is going year by years. So that means that there's a lot of opportunity investment in Vietnam, but if we can buy versus, have we ever think about if the Vietnamese company like Mr. Tuấn, one of the Vietnamese companies that come to Taiwan to invest, how gonna to be? So most of the Taiwanese come to Vietnam, and so how we imagine that one day the Vietnamese company will come to Taiwan to invest, to make the balance? Because lots of opportunity, I think, to fulfill the gap. And here, I would like to tell you what is the reason inside the gap. Because Taiwan, you know that the challenge is for Taiwan government and the Taiwan companies. So that means Taiwan, it is really difficult. I'm not going to talk about anything about the political. We talk about the investment and economic. But actually, Taiwan is very difficult to negotiate with other countries for the FTA. You know that it's a free trade agreement. Because Taiwan, they don't have the kind of the agreement. So it's really difficult to import and export. It's raising a lot of the tax. So that means that Taiwan need to find another partner, like the three partner. like Vietnam and Cambodia and a lot of countries in South Asia country, to make a factory, to build up a factory. And of course, they need to import a lot of raw material from Taiwan to go there, and a lot of import of a lot of equipment, merchant. So that will increase the import, the export value. So that means the gap, it really, it's coming, grow, it coming larger and larger. And so you can see that, you come back here, like you see Vietnam have a lot of benefit for the FTAs. We are belong of the ASEAN Association. Inside the ASEAN Association, more than 11 countries. That means we have the tax benefits. And also we have a lot of the individual FTA like Japan, Korea, European, Eurasia, which Russia is a big partner. And also we have another country like Chile. And we under negotiation in RCEP. RCEP, I think that RCEP is really important for Taiwan also. Taiwan is looking for Vietnam, if Vietnam can get into the RCEP.
Yes.
And we also have the one partner of the TPP. Taiwan is looking for the TPP opportunity. I think so. Even the USA, Donald Trump, they want to withdraw from the TPP, but TPP is still going on. I think so. I believe that. That means, and another thing here that I want to give you, like the GDP growth, that means the economic growth from Vietnam. You can see that is, I think it is impossible to compare Vietnam and Taiwan about the GDP growth. But here is a picture. I think I would like to give the picture. Here is the GDP growth from Vietnam recently, since 2012. So we have a really high diploma rate. It's coming. It's growing rapidly for the economies. So there are a lot of opportunities for investment here. That means our country attract a lot of investment, not only by Taiwan and other international countries. And you can see, if you, for the startup, I think there's a lot of the startup companies, like the SMEs, they're looking for the market and the consumer. They want to looking for, they have the best product. They have the high quality product, the good model of business, but they're looking for the customer. The customers will bring benefit for the company. So the Vietnam held more than 90 million people. It is a huge customer. It is a huge market, and it is a huge market, right? And so we also, if you consider about the infrastructure, like I mean the internet. Internet is a way to get people connect together, but it also is a B2C. That means the business connect to the customer. So we have the internet penetration about 40% in 2014. And you can see after 2 years, actually we have more than 35 million of people of our population can get to the internet and social media. And we have more than 29 million of people that using the smartphone to connect to the social media. So if you have one app, like Facebook, Instagram, or other product app, you can get a lot of customer here. It's a huge market. And you see that another thing I would like to give recommend here is we are the developed country. And we have a really, really stabilized politics that will keep that will reduce the risk of the money, the investment money. Do you want to invest money in the really, really rich, really rich and challenged market? So that is a key important thing. And we have more than 95 million of people. It's a huge market and huge customer. And for Taiwan, it also is a new opportunity for the company here and the startup also. The new Taiwanese government have implemented the new STARTBOARD policies, which is focused on the economic development. And with Taiwan looking for whole country in the Asia, I mean for the South Asia country and the India and the New Zealand and Australia, looking for the partner here. And the focus on the economies. But not only not exactly only focus on the economic issue. They also focus on another thing like the education, technology transfer, healthcare, and also startup and the SME development. I think there are a lot of opportunity there. But the people, the last year I attended this conference, like Taiwanese, the whole government, like the Taiwan and ASEAN strategic membership, which how Japan also is one partner of the forum. But people talk about the new policy. People talk about a lot of the policy, I think that so far. But what is the opportunity left behind? I think that's if you want to figure out what is a suitable opportunity and what is a suitable approach to the market, you need to analyze and understand what we need. Okay, so you want to invest in Vietnam, but what do you know about Vietnam? What is the requirement? What is the demand in our country? And in our country, I would like to give you the five domain here, the five areas. The first one, we need to integrate the technology. I mean the high technology, which is a benefit for the Taiwan. The first one is in agriculture field. We need a lot of the technology for the food science and the food prevention from the agriculture field and also the plan. And then the second thing here is for infrastructure. Vietnam is a developed country, so the infrastructure is the backbone of the economies. So we want to develop the roads, the transportation, and the public transportation, which is Taiwan is the top country leading the world. And also the number three here is the environment prevention. Taiwan is really good at this one. In Vietnam also, we have the 9H. It's really nightmare of dealing how to deal with the garbage, with the rubbish and the trash on the road. A lot of the waste, so we need to deal with. And another thing is renewable energy. Renewable energy like wind and solar energy is really important for us. And here's another one is healthcare. Healthcare system in Taiwan is really bad, really good. And so Vietnam, with more than 90 million of people, we have a lot of issue and a lot of the problem with the healthcare problem. So I think it's so kind of the industry we need to cooperate together. And I think that there are a lot of opportunity left behind, but the growing of the demands will driving a lot of opportunity. And I hope that you can take this opportunity and those kind of information can have food for you. And for the VNEAT, we are very straightforward to define the strategy for us. We find the partner in Taiwan, here is the Taiwan side. We're looking for, here is the Tai Sang Hui, do you know that? It's the council of the Taiwan Chamber and Committee in Vietnam. We're looking for the Tai Sang Hui's cooperation. Then because of Taiwan, we want to connect with the Taiwanese enterprise. A lot of the Taiwanese companies for the human resource and the talent exchange. So for a lot of the students, Vietnamese students, they graduate, they can find job for the Taiwanese company. And the second thing here is we're looking for a cooperation with the Ministry of the Science and Technology in Taiwan, which is the Taiwanese government organization, to help and support and to cooperate with the R&D, the research and the shoulder. I think the research and R&D and the technology transfer is very important for us. And we also want to connect with the mutual funds because we are looking for the cooperation with the STARTBOARD. For example, is a STARTBOARD and startup incubator. Yeah, STARTBOARD is a really competitive partner. We are looking for the cooperation.
Yeah, that's the reason why we invite you here, that we hope in the future we can seek for some further visions.
Yes, thank you so much. And from the Vietnamese side, we have a lot of resources here. We are connect with the Ministry of the Science and Technology of Vietnam governments, and to connect with the Vietnamese enterprise. So we got a lot of the demands from the Vietnamese companies. So after that, we can transfer and so kind of the demands brought to a lot of our partner here and for our member. So we can analyze and we can work together and to figure out the solution. And we can make a connection between two sides. That is really straightforward, about the strategy. Yeah, here you can see that we are looking for the business model. And most of the people, they're looking for, okay, we figure out the business model is changing from the B2C. C2C. But we're looking for, we will create another new one, is that is a people to people. I think that's very important. We connect to people, not only by the business to customer, not by the customer to customer. We connect to people, between two sides. That is the idea for VNEAT. So anyway, that is. I hope those kind of information will help you to figure out what is the challenge, and what is the opportunity left behind. And we're looking forward for the new future, for near future cooperation. Thank you so much.
VNEAT just point out one of the very important I mentioned in the beginning, that we recognize the key thing is not about the business or any trend. It's more about people. So when you can connect people, we stay stronger and more connected. I believe that we can do many things for the future. So right now, I would like to invite to the stage Mr. Uniform and Mr. Raymond to give the certificate for the guest speaker that are attending our event today. I really wish we can have more time for the question and answer, but later on you will have the networking session to exchange more information, question and answer. So all the guest speaker, please standing here. So along the beginning, we mentioned a lot about starboard like this, starboard like that, and starboard doing this thing, starboard have this company. But we actually haven't delivered an exact message. So right now, one of my team member, Juvina, she will have a presentation, a very short one, believe me, a very short one about what is starboard and what we're doing. So thank you, Juvina. Welcome.
Hello, everyone. My name is Juvina, and I come from India. And I'd like to welcome each and every one of you tonight. Thank you for coming. We worked really hard, and we're very glad that you appreciate our work, and I hope you're enjoying the event tonight. I'm just going to give you a brief introduction about what Startboard is and what we do at Startboard. So Startboard, as we all know, is an incubation center. Now, what we do is we don't just focus on startups who are based in Taiwan. We also focus on startups who are from other parts of Asian countries or India. So if you are a startup company who wants to start something in Taiwan, or who is already a startup and wants to grow into the market of Taiwan, you can still come contact us. But we have certain rules that, certain criteria or prerequisites, I would say. Why Startboard? First, because Startboard is the only and the first platform for Asian and Indian students with entrepreneurial aspiration and Taiwanese teams. So if, for example, if you're a team of four people, you come from different backgrounds, but you have one member in your team who is from any of the Asian countries, Southeast Asian countries, or India, then you're good to go with us. Then we encourage Asian Indian talents in Taiwan to start business. So for example, if you're a graduate or you're going to graduate, but you have an idea about starting something in Taiwan, but unfortunately you do not have any mentor or you don't know where to go, who to begin with, you can come to us. we nurture innovative ideas. Startboard is the place where we value ideas. If you have any idea that you think is a potential one and has the ability to grow in a market like Taiwan, please, you can come to us. We also create ties between Taiwanese enterprises who are developing in the markets or who are interested in developing in Southeast Asian countries and India, of course. What Startboard provides to our batches or our teams? Startboard provides complete assistance for entrepreneurial visa. Until last year, Taiwan did not have entrepreneurial visa. Right now we do, and we have a team, our seniors, Charlotte and Uniform. We will provide complete assistance for any startup company who's looking for entrepreneurial visa. Government resources, we have several tie-ups with several big government companies in Taiwan, and our boss has very, very good links with them, and it's very helpful for startup companies. Co-working space, we currently have 5 co-working space all around Taiwan. Co-working space, as in, since you're a startup company, you might not have the enough funds or sufficient funds to find a place for yourself where you could do weekly meetings or a regular catch up with your team. We provide that space, and it's for free, everything. Then we also have consulting. We provide weekly consulting. Every week we have meetings with our teams where we discuss with them how is the plan going, how is their business going, and where are they, if they're moving forward, if they have any kind of difficulty. We sit and we consult with them. We give them all the solutions that they need. Events, like tonight, we have several events, themed nights, chat shows, other kind of events where we invite all our teams, and through these events they can find partners, other batches, other team members, they can find mentors, they can also find recruitments, and they can also find interns, colleagues, workers. It's just a lot. Through events we provide a lot of other stuff. These are our co-working space. This is in Taipei, it's just TAF. It's very close to Zhongxiao Shenzhen. Then we have iFoundry, Inno Square, and these two places are in Taichung. This one is in Fengjia University, and one is in Oriental Plaza. These places, if you're a startup based in Taichung or Taipei, you could use these places for your weekly meetings. These are our mentors who support our team, and we are very glad to have their support.